Hello everyone, welcome back to Malu Sasi's channel. I hope everybody is in good health and still positive and hopeful with this pandemic going on. Hopefully when the vaccine comes, everything will be fine and we'll be back to normal. We just hope that the vaccine will really work for all of us. My topic for today, guys, would be about the federal skilled worker under express entry. So for those who haven't subscribed yet, you are free to do so. You may also hit like and that notification bell. You may also want to leave some comments. In this channel, I discuss about the life of an immigrant here in Canada. And once in a while, I also talk about the immigration process you guys may want to consider in coming over. So if you are with me, please stay tuned. Federal Skilled Worker Program. How does it work? Para sa program na ito, guys, we have three minimum requirements. Number one is skilled work experience. Number two would be the language ability. And number three is education. Ano ba yung skilled work experience na kailangan for the first requirement? It means that you've worked in one of the three groups set by the National Occupational Classification or NOC. Number one is managerial job or skill type O. Number two is professional job or skill level A. Number three is technical jobs and skilled trades, skill level B. Dapat isa sa mga yan ang primary occupation mo for the last 10 years. Dapat din ay paid work, not volunteer, nor unpaid internship. Dapat regular na trabaho. At sa loob ng 10 taon na hinihingi nila na dapat ay nakapagtrabaho ka sa loob ng 10 years, dapat meron kang 1 year doon na continuous work experience under that category ng job na yon. Yung 1 year continuous work na hinihingi ni Canada can be equivalent to 1,560 hours or 30 hours per week work. See, very particular si Canada sa mga bagay na yan. Detailed talaga siya. This 1,560 hours, by the way, can be met in three ways. Number one, full-time work with 30 hours per week for 12 months would be equivalent to 1,560 hours. Number two, if you work part-time at one job, like 15 hours per week only for 24 months or 2 years, diba? So that would also be equivalent to 1,560 hours. Number three, as part-time for more than one job, 30 hours per week for 12 months, that would also be equivalent to 1,560 hours. Now, the second minimum requirement, the language ability. I'm sure we are familiar about IELTS. IELTS means International English Language Testing System. So, importante na seryosohin ang bagay na ito. I remember back then when I was about to take my IELTS, I insist that we speak English at home, I read materials in English, I watch TV programs in English, I watch movies in English, and I even went to a review center for IELTS para lang makakuha ng magandang score. Well, of course, ang mas taas na score dyan would be a great advantage. You will need the test in 4 abilities, writing, reading, listening, and speaking. So, ang gusto ni Canada na ma-obtain ng isang applicant would be CLB 7, guys, ang equivalent score niyan sa IELTS would be 6, number 6. So, at least makakuha kayo ng score na 6 in all abilities sa apat na yon. 2 years naman ang validity ng IELTS results, so that's good enough. Now, the third and last minimum requirement would be education. You need to have a completed credential. You will need a diploma, a certificate, or trade or apprenticeship credential issued for completing a program of study or training at a recognized educational or training institution. Also, ia-assess din niya ni Canada through ECA. ECA is Educational Credential Assessment. Of course, para masigurado na yung training or program na completed sa bansa mo equivalent sa standard ni Canada. So there you have it, my dear friends. I have talked about the Federal Skilled Worker Under Express Entry. Para po sa mga nangangarap magpunta dito, tiyaga lang. As I've been saying, planning is the key. These days, we can only do so much. So this is the perfect time to plan ahead for the things that we wanted to do for the next few months or the next few years. So yan po mga kaibigan ang aking video for today. Salamat sa pakikinig at I hope that you stay tuned for my next videos in the future. I will see you soon.